It's one of the most unwelcoming places on Earth, a desert almost devoid of human life, yet home to one of the most marvelous pieces of engineering under construction. In Chile's Atacama Desert, men and women are building the world's largest telescope, a colossal construction site with record numbers and stakes isolated from the rest of the world. A device designed to advance our understanding of the universe and perhaps even enable us to discover forms of life on other planets. While we keep our feet firmly planted on the ground, for this new episode of Looking For, we're off to discover the stars and their secrets thanks to the extremely large telescope. To find your way to the construction site of this new object, you'll need to be well informed. The extremely large telescope, commonly known as the ELT, is located on the summit of Cerro Armazones. This 3,000-meter-high platform is located in the northern part of Chile, almost 1,300 kilometers from the capital, Santiago. The nearest town, Taltal, is 130 kilometers away. To get there, you have to tackle the Atacama Desert, one of the driest places on the planet, wedged between the Andes and the Pacific Ocean. An expanse of desert offering breathtaking scenery, a place sometimes reminiscent of the Moon or even Mars, with its glowing soil stretching as far as the eye can see. A soil that may soon be trodden by man, at least if we are to believe the statements of the billionaire owner of Tesla and SpaceX, Elon Musk. But of all the space available in Chile, why choose the Atacama Desert to build the world's future jewel in the crown of astronomy? In reality, this location was chosen not for its similarities with the landscapes of faraway stars, but for its inhospitable conditions. Here, rain is a rare, if not exceptional, event. The site ensures more than 320 clear nights a year, according to local authorities. Remote from the rest of the world, the ELT is also unaffected by visual pollution from human lighting sources. Observation conditions are therefore optimal for astronomers. The site is not unfamiliar. 20 kilometers away, the Very Large Telescope has already been deployed. At the moment, the VLT is considered to be the most powerful terrestrial observatory in the field of visible light, but it will be overtaken by the ELT when it opens. More generally, Chile is a land of choice for astronomers, since 70% of the world's observations are made in this South American country. However, there is no rivalry for space surveillance between the two sites. In fact, they both belong to the European Southern Observatory. This intergovernmental organization has been in place since 1962. It brings together 16 European countries. Two other countries are associated, Australia and Chile, where it has built observatories. Over 65% of its budget comes from Germany, the UK, France, and Italy. The primary aim of this organization is to build and operate ground-based observatories to promote astronomical discoveries. Its equipment and researchers have already contributed to major breakthroughs. In 2022, for example, it helped reveal to the world the first image of a black hole in our galaxy, the Milky Way. But the European Southern Observatory continues to push back the boundaries of astronomy by developing ever more powerful instruments. In 2010, the decision was taken to build the extremely large telescope. Initially scheduled to go into service in 2018, it is due to be operational as early as 2028. On July 11, 2023, the ESO announced that construction was halfway complete. And when it comes to contemplating the infinite and beyond, the observatory is not cutting any corners. According to official estimates, the ELT project will ultimately cost almost 1.5 billion euros. It's a Titanic project which didn't begin with a symbolic foundation stone, but rather with explosives. To accommodate the immense platform, the summit of the Cerro Armazones mountain had to be leveled, a task begun in 2014. A total of 220,000 cubic meters of rock were removed. Once the surface had been leveled to a width of 150 meters and a length of 300 meters, a huge concrete slab was poured to create the platform for the observatory. Since then, between 160 and 220 people have been working on the site every day under extreme conditions. The area's low humidity means that organisms dry out very quickly, so you need to drink a lot. To be as close as possible to the stars, the telescope construction site is also high up. At this altitude, UV rays are more intense, so workers need to dress accordingly. Today, the skeleton of a dome of exceptional dimensions takes shape, 88 meters wide and 80 meters high. To give you an idea, the Statue of Liberty reaches a height of 93 meters with its base. It could almost fit inside this behemoth under construction. And there's no shortage of figures to remember about this megastructure. A new example is the weight of the dome, which totals almost 6,100 tons. The dome's two doors, which will open and close according to the telescope's use, will each weigh around 400 tons. The whole system will be based on a 360-degree slide system so that astronomers can point at any part of the starry sky. This impressive system will be made up of 36 huge carriages, each weighing 20 tons. And to keep the whole site running, a photovoltaic power plant has even been built in the area around the ELT. Finally, to counter the seismic risk so prevalent in this part of the world, the structure contains a double seismic system with a mechanism made up of hydraulic jacks and dampers specially created for the telescope. But there's another danger looming: flames. In the event of fire, it's difficult to wait here for the fire department to arrive, so you need to have your own reserves. To this end, tanks have been set up and filled with water in the basement to put out potential fires. All this will be used to protect the jewel in the crown of the dome, the telescope itself. This will be equipped with five gigantic mirrors that will transmit light to the scientists' instruments. The primary mirror, which will collect the light first, is a prototype of exceptional dimensions. Incurved, it will measure almost 39 meters in diameter, far larger than any of today's working mirrors. Even in space, it can't compare. The James Webb Telescope, a marvel of technology launched at the end of December 2021, has a mirror measuring just 6.5 meters. Its unique position at the heart of the Milky Way enables it to send back images that redefine our vision of space. On its website, the ESO provides a series of comparisons to demonstrate the power of its new lens. The ELT's mirror should collect 100 million times more light than the human eye, 8 million times more than Galileo's telescope, and even 10 to 15 times more than the VLT currently receives. And the more light the mirror can collect, the more distant and faint images it can collect. This is essential if we are to see further and more accurately. This record-breaking mirror will be made up of 798 hexagonal segments, each 1.5 meters in diameter. These elements are currently being made in Europe, using special materials to improve their durability and performance. Among other materials, they are made from zero dur, a glass ceramic that is particularly resistant to the temperature variations that can be extreme in this desert location. They are then coated with a thin layer of silver, a material with particularly high reflectivity. Once manufactured, they will be shipped to Chile. The first 18 segments were sent to the site at the end of 2023. Once on site, they must be assembled, a crucial task requiring the greatest precision, with margins calculated in hundredths of micrometers. To ensure maximum performance, this gigantic mirror will undergo constant renovation. The various segments will be resurfaced to maintain maximum reflectivity. Every day, two new segments will receive a brand new layer of silver. Another record-breaking feature of the telescope is the width of the second mirror. This is the mirror on which the primary mirror focuses all the light it collects. It is considerably smaller, measuring just 4 meters in diameter, yet it will be the widest mirror of its kind in the world. Another special feature is that it will be set at a height of over 60 meters at the very end of the telescope. The light will then pass through three other reflectors, all of which play a part in making the image as clear and sharp as possible. This new eye on space, as it is nicknamed, is eagerly awaited by scientists the world over, and with good reason. According to forecasts, the ELT telescope is set to increase the current capacity for observing our starry skies by a factor of 5,000. A breakthrough that should make it possible to go back in time thanks to the speed of light, because light doesn't arrive instantaneously. For example, it takes about 8 minutes for sunlight to reach us. This means that when you watch a sunset here on Earth, you're only observing the sun as it was 8 minutes before. However, if we look further into the universe, we can go back much further into the past and discover, for example, the image of a galaxy in its first starbursts. With its enhanced vision, this new telescope will enable us to observe more of the universe, learning more about its workings and history. Its use will also clarify questions currently under discussion in the field of astronomical research. The recent discovery of exoplanets, for example, is partly due to the commissioning of the latest, most powerful telescopes a few years ago. But above all, the ELT will enable us to reach other distances in the universe, places that have yet to be explored. Space exploration, with its share of unknowns, is already sending scientists around the world into a frenzy. With a telescope like this, we'll be pushing back the boundaries so much that we're expecting a lot of unpredictable discoveries, explains ELT scientific director Michele Cirasuolo. What's more, will the new telescope be able to locate a planet with conditions favorable to the development of life? The question will remain open until at least 2028, but the hypothesis is certainly on the table. However, the ELT is not the only new generation telescope currently under construction. There are two other projects of smaller dimensions, but with equivalent scientific ambitions. The first is the GMT, the Giant Magellan Telescope. Unlike the ELT, its primary mirror will not be made up of several hundred hexagons. Here, researchers have opted for the construction of seven mirrors, each over 8 meters in diameter. Together, they will function as a single mirror 25 meters in diameter. It is scheduled for completion in 2029 at the Las Campanas Observatory in Chile. Another giant is the TMT, which stands for 30-meter telescope. Its name refers to the size of its primary mirror. The project will take place in Hawaii, on the slopes of Mauna Kea, the extinct volcano that dominates the island. At an altitude of over 4,000 meters, the peak offers ideal conditions for observing distant stars. The problem is that the site is also considered sacred by some of the island's indigenous population, who have been protesting the construction for 10 years now. And so it is with these ongoing projects that we part company today. I hope you enjoy this new video, and if so, feel free to subscribe to the channel. Thank you for watching, and see you soon on Looking 4.